Hi, my name is Muhammad Sibian Azman. I am a tester from Sports Legal Company from Group 4. And today, I would like to brief a bit what I'm going to talk about today. For the first one will be our product explanation, and the second one will be our apps explanation. So let's go. Actually, we have developed an application that users are able to rent several sport equipment and facilities such as cone, racket, shoes and ball. The reason we developed this project is because of a certain aspect and problem that some community have faced, especially during sport activities. After in-depth research, we have found that some people didn't own some sport equipment such as rackets and shoes. For example, in badminton sport, some people couldn't afford to buy a racket and shoes because of their expensive prices. The second one, same goes to the futsal sports. Some team, they do not own a proper futsal shoes and other purpose equipment such as extra ball or cone for drill practice. As we know that if we wear an improper equipment or shoes, it will lead someone to any unprecedented harm, and also it will leave some damage or marks at the badminton court or futsal. And now, I will introduce our new application, Sports Do Go, an online sport renting application. So now, let's go through the app's explanation. Come on.
Thank you, Hasif, for the explanation. So let me proceed. My name is Muhammad Afiqman bin Nur Azman, and I'm the manager for this project. So in order to connect with this app, I will show you how to use the mobile application. So let's go. So first of all, we need to register our username and all details in our registration button. So we click the register button, and we need to put our username. So for example, I just put Fir. So email fir@gmail.com, and my password, I can put maybe fir. The password must be at least 8 characters. So telephone number 018. So that's all for registration page. So we can click the sign up button, and the sign up button will be success. So after we have our account, so we need to log in again. So in our login, we just put our email. So my email just now is fir@gmail.com, and my password is fir. So then we can click the login button. So after we click the login button, the home page will appear in our screen. So what we can do is we can select either sport categories. So for this, I'll just show you one sport category, maybe badminton, or maybe I can show you how to select the futsal button. So in futsal category, you can see that there are three items. So first thing, we need to insert the hour that we want to rent this item. So I can just put 1 hour, maybe 1 hour. So I have clothes, I have shoes, so I can just rent 2 bits. So we need to first confirm, then check out. So we click the confirm button, and in the trolley we'll have 2 items that we have rented. So we can go to check out. After we finish, the checkout list will appear there, all the renting items that we have made. So we can go to proceed. So in this page, we need to get QR code for us to be scanned by the owner of the facilities. So we can get QR code. So this QR code is very important for us. So after we finish and done, So we can just go to back button. So I think that's all, and we can check our history status if you want to. So I can just go back, and if we click the back button, we'll go back to the login page. So if I am the admin, so I need to just simply put my email again, gmail.com, and put my password again. Then I go to admin. So in admin, there will be a scan QR or history. The customer or the client or user came to my facility and want to pay for the renting items. So I can click at the QR, scan QR, and then what is need to scan the QR code. So when I done my scanning QR code, so will appear the user list, and I can check the history. Yes, this is the number for the user or client, so that I can check it in the data. So that's all from this application testing. So thank you.